हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी आर रीडिंग यूनिट 12, टू जेंटलमैन ऑफ वरुणा। सो इन द लास्ट टू क्लासेस यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन, द ऑथर, एंड देन वी स्टार्टेड रीडिंग द एक्चुअल लेसन इन द लास्ट क्लास। एंड वी सॉ दैट रैदर वी रेड दैट टू बॉयज निकोला एंड जेकोपो वर सेलिंग fruits on the outskirts of Varuna, where the narrator and his friend came across them. Okay, so go through the last part of the lesson once again, I mean the last week's part, so that you can understand what we are reading in this week. Okay, so for your text reference, open your textbook to page number 103. We are reading first, second, third paragraph onwards, from page number 103. Which paragraph? I'll just give a hint and read one sentence from there, so that you can start following the lesson. Keep the textbook in front of you, because in the next coming up slides, I have given you point wise summary of the lesson, because I have not put it as it is in the textbook, because the textbook already you are having, right? So I have cut short the sentences and made them short, so that we fit in the duration of the online class given to us. Okay, so start reading from page number 103, paragraph number 1, 2, third paragraph from top, which is that one night we came upon them in the windy and deserted square, resting on the stone pavement beneath the pale arc lights. That is the paragraph we are reading the lesson from. So, one night they were surprised to see the boys in the windy and deserted square. Who are they here? The narrator and his friend. To see the boys. Which boys? The two boys, same two boys who did many number of jobs, many different jobs, Nicola and Jacopo. So they were sitting on the roadside beneath the lights. It was nearly midnight, and though he looked tired, Nicola sat upright while Jacopo slept with his head resting on his brother's shoulder. So, even though they both were very tired, the elder one, that is Nicola, was sitting straight, you know, steady, and Jacopo slept with his head resting on the other's shoulder. They were waiting for the last bus from Padua, so that they could sell the newspapers. So it was a very windy night and a deserted square. Deserted means very less people traveled over that place. It was not a very crowded place. That is what deserted means. But the author and his friend were wondering, the two young boys, so small boys, in this kind of situation at such late midnight, why they were waiting at that square. So then they came to know that the two boys were waiting for the last bus, which was coming from Padua, so that the heap of newspapers which they had still to be sold, they wanted to sell that bundle of newspapers to the passengers in the bus. That is why they were waiting for the last bus. The narrator was surprised at how hard the boys worked, and when he questioned Nicola about it the next morning, he looked ashamed and tongue-tied. Tongue-tied means not ready to speak up clearly, not ready to tell whatever he had in his mind. So the narrator was surprised why these two boys are working so hard. Probably there might be some reason, but the narrator was worried, or rather he was curious to know why these two boys were working so hard. What was the need for them to wait till midnight to sell the newspapers? The narrator presumed the boys worked so hard and spent frugally as they were saving up to immigrate to America. So after seeing that the two boys did different jobs every day, like they polished shoes, they sold newspapers, they sold fruits, they acted as guides taking the tourists around the city of Verona, and even after all this they did all kind of work, you know, honest work which was giving them some money. So the narrator presumed, means he thought for himself, that maybe the boys are working so hard because they want to save money, they want to make some money and then go to America. Okay. Nicola expressed a desire to go to the States, but said they had plans in Italy at the moment. When the narrator approached the two boys on the next morning and asked them, "Why do you boys work so hard? What is the need for you to earn so much of money by doing so many jobs? Do you want to go to America?" That is what he asked them. So Nicola said, "Of course, sir, we would like to go to America, but right now we have different plans." The narrator then offered help before he left for the United States on the following Monday. So the narrator and his friend had come to the city of Verona, and it was a week now, and they had all seen everything in Verona. Sightseeing was over, holiday was over, enjoying was over. So now it was time for the narrator to go back to his place. Then, because the narrator was, you know, very much impressed with the boys' hard working, their honesty, their politeness, their sincerity, you know. So overall the boys had impressed the narrator a lot, and he somehow wanted to extend some kind of help to the two boys. Like, he was thinking, what can I do for these boys? So he approached them and asked them, "See, I am going back to my place on Monday. So is there anything that I can do for you?" Then what happened was, when the narrator asked what help he could do to them, Jacopo immediately, you know, was having that glow in his eyes, and he answered something. But Nicola, what happened? He said, "No, sir, we don't take help from anyone, and it is okay. Whatever work we did, you have paid money for that. It is fine." But the younger one, who was very lively, happy, you know, Jacopo, he immediately stood up and said, like, "Sir, if you want at all to help us, or you want to do any favor for us, then what you can do is, see, every Sunday we go to a place called Poletta, which is 30 kilometers from Verona. So we actually you know, hire cycles." Hire means giving money and borrowing it for some time. Hire. "We actually hire bicycles to go till Poletta. So if at all you want to do something for us, then you have such a big nice car, why don't you take us in your car on this Sunday to Poletta?" Jacopo offered this. Then, but somehow Nicola was not very happy taking help from, you know, strangers, people whom we don't know. He was a bit hesitant, but finally he also agreed. And the narrator at least was ready enough to help the two boys. So the narrator readily agreed to drive the car himself and take the boys to Poleta on the coming Sunday. Then after they went there, what happened? While they were going, you can read on page number 105, first paragraph. The following afternoon, we drove to the tiny picturesque village set high upon the hillside amidst sheltering chestnut groves with a few pines on the upper slopes and a deep blue lake beneath. I imagined that our destinations would be some humble dwelling, but directed by Jacopo's shrill treble, we drove up a large red-roofed villa surrounded by a high stone wall. I could scarcely believe my eyes, and before I could recover breath, my two passengers had leaped nimbly from the car. So, as they were driving that afternoon, when they went to Poleta, the narrator drove the car himself and the two boys sitting in the car, they all three went. While on the way, the narrator was thinking, okay, they earn money. These two boys, you know, work and do different jobs for the whole week, Monday to Saturday, and earn and save money. And then on Sunday, they are going to some, picnic spot or some resort or something, and then they are going to spend that money and have fun. So that might be their plan. That is what the narrator was thinking. But what happened? When Jacopo told the narrator to stop the car that they want to get down, that was a big red roofed villa and it was surrounded by a high stone wall. As soon as the car came to a halt, the two boys jumped out, telling the narrator that they would be back in an hour, and they entered the villa. Now it was a villa, is a very big house, mansion, so it was like that. And then the narrator didn't understand why these two boys have come here and what is there inside the villa, what they are going to do there, what for they have come to this villa. It was not understood. It was a mystery for the narrator. Then what happened? They both got down quickly from the car and Nicola told the narrator, "Sir, you can go down to the village and have a cup of coffee for yourself, and we will be back to this place in 1 hour." What does that mean? Indirectly, Nicola said or indicated that they did not want the narrator to come along with them inside the villa, inside the mansion that they were going. So where they were going, Nicola doesn't want the narrator to know what for they have come here. He wants to keep something secret. So he says, "Sir, you have dropped us till here. We will be back in 1 hour. Till that time, you go down to the village and have a cup of coffee." And they both, entered the villa and disappeared. They went inside the villa. They disappeared beyond the corner of the wall. But what happened? The narrator was very much, anxious to know, very eager to know. He was very curious to know what is inside the villa, what these boys are going to do here for 1 hour. So it was very much exciting and causing lot of anxiety for the narrator, and he could not stop himself. So what he did? He silently, secretly followed the two boys and went behind the two boys inside the villa. When a few minutes had elapsed, I followed. Means the narrator also followed the two boys. He also went behind the two boys there. I found a grilled side entrance and determinedly rang the bell. So there was a grill gate there and he rang the bell there. A pleasant looking woman with a ruddy complexion and steel-rimmed spectacles appeared. So, a lady appeared there who wore spectacles. I blinked as I saw that she was dressed in the white uniform of a trained nurse. So, the lady who came to open the grilled gate was a nurse. She was dressed like a nurse. We know, you have seen a nurse and her uniform, right? So, she was looking like a nurse. Then the narrator said, I just brought two boys here. So, he asked the nurse that the two boys who just now entered the villa and went inside somewhere, I have also come along with them. Ah, yes. Her face lit up. She opened the door to admit me. Nicola and Jacopo, I will take you up. So now the nurse understood that the narrator wants to know where the two boys are. So she said, the two boys who came just now, yes, I know, Nicola and Jacopo. Yes, do you want to see them? Do you want to meet them? Do you want to know where they have gone, what they are doing? Yes, I will take you to them. So the nurse said to the narrator that she will guide him where the boys have gone. So this is on page number 105. Now of 105 number page, only the last paragraph remains, and from there we will take up in our next class. So even you keep up the curiosity where the two boys have gone, or if you have the textbook, go through it, you will understand. So see you in the next class. Bye.